The possibility of Earth experiencing a new ice age is a topic that has been the subject of debate among scientists. The Earth is in a geological epoch known as the Quaternary, characterized by glacial and interglacial cycles. The Earth is also known to be going through an interglacial period which began approximately 11,000 years ago. This being so, would it be possible for the Earth to go through a new ice age? And if it happens, would humanity survive? Join us on this journey of knowledge to find out. Historically, ice ages have been associated with changes in the Earth's orbit and axial inclination, known as Milankovitch orbital parameters, which we have already discussed in previous videos. These changes affect the amount and distribution of solar radiation that reaches Earth, which can trigger glacial episodes. During an ice age, there are repetitive cooling and warming cycles classified as glacial periods and interglacial periods. Glacial periods are characterized by the expansion of ice layers on the Earth's surface, producing glaciers covering huge land and ocean surface areas. It is also a prolonged period in which conditions are much colder throughout the planet. Ecosystems change and flora and fauna adapt to colder climates where snow predominates. Worm glaciation, the Ice Age, is the last glacial period in the Earth's geological history. It began about 110,000 years ago and ended around 9700 BC, giving way to the Holocene, the period of current temperate climate. Between glacial periods, there are warmer intervals known as interglacial periods. An interglacial period is a phase in which global temperatures reach warmer temperatures, which causes less glacial formation throughout the planet, and is characterized by a time interval in which the Earth's global temperature is relatively warmer. The ice sheets in the polar region are less extensive compared to the more extended and colder glacial periods. In the current context, the Earth is in an interglacial period that began approximately 11,000 years ago, marking the end of the last ice age. During this time, temperatures have been relatively warmer, allowing the development of human civilizations and agriculture in regions that were previously covered by ice. Is a new ice age approaching? The occurrence of a new ice age, also known as glaciation, would be influenced by a series of complex and primarily long-scale factors. Historically, ice ages have been associated with changes in Earth's orbital parameters, known as Milankovitch cycles. This includes changes in the eccentricity of the Earth's orbit around the Sun, the axial inclination, and the precession of the orbit. The factor that most influences the Earth's climate is not human activity, but radiation from the Sun. If the Earth's orbit or its inclination changes, the amount of radiation that reaches us from the Sun also changes. Therefore, the Milankovitch cycle influences the temperature of the planet. Although variations in the total amount of solar radiation are relatively small, the slightest change in the Earth's tilt or orbit can produce enormous changes in the year's seasons. Let us remember that the Earth's orbit around the Sun is not circular but elliptical. So there is a point known as perihelion in which the Earth is closest to the Sun, and a point called aphelion in which the Earth is farthest from the Sun. Currently, summers in the northern hemisphere occur when the Earth is at its farthest point, that is, at the aphelion, at which the North Pole is tilted towards the Sun, resulting in longer and hotter days and shorter nights in that region, because the amount of solar radiation received in the northern hemisphere is more significant. But at the same time, in the southern hemisphere, it is winter, as the South Pole tilts away from the Sun, resulting in shorter days and longer, colder nights. But if the Earth's orbit around the Sun changed so that instead of being elliptical, it was more circular, and at the same time the tilt axis of the Earth would change so that the North Pole would face the opposite side of the Sun for a longer time, temperatures at the North Pole would be much lower than today. Simply put, when these orbital variations are aligned in a certain way, they can contribute to a climate more conducive to forming ice sheets. Internal cycles of the climate system. The inherent complexity of the climate system, including phenomena such as ocean circulation, ice cover, and thermal absorption, play an essential role in determining long-term climate patterns. Today, it is known that some factors such as ocean circulation and the distribution of polar caps can significantly influence the entire global climate. This is because approximately 70% of the planet's surface is covered by water. Therefore, changes in ocean temperatures significantly influence the climate around the world. For example, slight changes in salt concentration in the sea can cause significant changes in the polar caps. Let us remember that the salinity of seawater affects its freezing point. Fresh water freezes faster and easier than salt water. If ocean salinity somehow decreased, polar caps would form more quickly and in more significant quantities. Could this happen? Well, today we know that due to the increase in global temperatures, glaciers and polar caps are melting, contributing large amounts of fresh water to the ocean. Since this fresh water has low or no salt concentration, its incorporation into the ocean can reduce salinity and lead to the formation of polar ice caps and the rise of glaciers. Ice and snow reflect sunlight better than darker ocean water. If the amount of ice at the poles increased, the amount of sunlight reflected to space would also increase, leading to a drop in global temperature. That is to say, a simple change such as a decrease in seawater salinity could contribute to ice formation at the poles, and therefore to a decrease in global temperatures. Although we are going through an interglacial period where global temperatures are generally warm, we cannot rule out that a new ice age will occur in the not-so-distant future, which could bring extremely low temperatures similar to the last ice age. If so, could humanity survive a new ice age, or would it end civilization as we know it? Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Children of Ice. If a new ice age occurred, what temperatures would there be in the world? During Earth's last ice age, known as the Wisconsin Glaciation or the Last Ice Age, global temperatures were between 7 and 14 degrees Fahrenheit in regions near the tropics and the equator. During this period, large expanses of ice covered much of North America, Europe, and Asia in what is today known as the North American and Eurasian ice sheets. These ice sheets significantly affected the landscape and weather patterns. If the planet were to enter a new ice age, it is possible that these would be the predominant temperatures in areas near the equator. Still, for areas near the poles, such as Antarctica and the Arctic, the temperatures would be 20 degrees Fahrenheit lower than they are today. That is to say, currently the average temperature in the Arctic Circle ranges from minus 50 to minus 45 degrees Fahrenheit. During a new ice age, the average temperature in these regions could reach minus 70 degrees Fahrenheit, which could at times easily reach minus 95 degrees Fahrenheit, temperatures at which most living beings could not survive. Furthermore, ecosystems would change drastically and tropical areas and humid jungles would disappear, giving way to a more polar environment with cold air, fewer leafy trees, and more snow. Most animals adapted to tropical climates would die, and those that survive would have to adapt to a colder environment, where white would be the predominant color. As the tundra and taiga area increases, most crop areas would be lost, and all crops would have to be grown indoors or in special facilities, where the crops would be safe and protected from the cold outside. What would happen to humanity? Nowadays, cities in different countries worldwide have adapted very well to the cold climate, such as Norilsk in Russia, Barrow in Alaska, USA, Yellowknife in Canada, and Yakutsk in Russia. Although these cities depend primarily on products and services from abroad, it is proven that humans can live in cold places without problems. What is a fact is that the human race would survive a new ice age, although many things would be different from what we know. Due to the rise of the polar caps and the drop in temperature in areas near the poles and the polar circles, most people living in cities close to these areas will surely migrate to areas closer to the equator, where temperatures would not be so extreme. In addition, cities would be reconditioned to adapt to the new reality. Buildings would be made to withstand freezing temperatures and cold winds, and shopping centers and probably entire cities would have to be built wholly roofed or underground, where people could live their lives without being exposed to freezing temperatures. Clothing and vehicles would also change. Since temperatures will be below zero most of the time, we cannot depend on electric cars, but we cannot use only combustion cars since the fuel would freeze. Perhaps changing temperatures will force us to develop new transportation methods that are more efficient in the extreme cold. On the other hand, clothing would be different from what we wear today, as it would be designed to withstand lower temperatures, and it would probably be impossible to live without wearing thermal clothing. In short, although it would be challenging at first, humans could adapt and survive a new ice age. However, we must consider that some scientists suggest that, although we are currently in an interglacial period, human activities, mainly the emission of greenhouse gases, could significantly impact the future climate, counteracting the conditions that would typically lead to a new ice age. In other words, although the Earth has always gone through periods like the one we are experiencing, if human activities drastically change the climate instead of a new ice age, we may face intense global warming. But in the end, the last answer lies with you. Please tell us what you think. Do you think it is more likely that we will face a new ice age or that the future will be hotter than today? Let us know your opinion with your valuable comments.